Novena to the Holy Spirit, for the seven gifts. In the name of the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Day 4, Thou in toil art comfort sweet, pleasant coolness in the heat, solace in the midst of woe. The Gift of Fortitude. By the gift of fortitude, the soul is strengthened, against natural fear, and supported to the end in the performance of duty. Fortitude imparts to the will an impulse and energy, which move it to undertake, without hesitancy, the most arduous tasks. To face dangers, to trample human respect, and to endure without complaint, the slow martyrdom of lifelong tribulation. He that shall persevere unto the end, he shall be saved. Prayer. Come, O blessed Spirit of fortitude, uphold my soul in time of trouble and adversity. Sustain my efforts for holiness, strengthen my weaknesses, and give me courage against all the assaults of my enemies. That I may never be separated from Thee, my God and greatest good. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name, Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sinned against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Act of consecration to the Holy Spirit. On my knees, before the great multitude of heavenly witnesses, I offer myself, soul and body to you, eternal Spirit of God. I adore the brightness of your purity, the unerring keenness of your justice, and the might of your love. You are the strength and light of my soul. In you, I live, move and am. I desire never to grieve you, by unfaithfulness to grace, and I pray with all my heart, to be kept from the smallest sin against you. Mercifully guard my every thought, and grant, that I may always watch for your light, listen to your voice, and follow your gracious inspirations. I cling to you, and give myself to you, and ask you, by your compassion, to watch over me in my weakness. Holding the pierced feet of Jesus, and looking at his five wounds, trusting in his precious blood and adoring his open side and stricken heart, I implore you, adorable Spirit, helper of my infirmity, to keep me in your grace, that I may never sin against you. Give me grace, O Holy Spirit, Spirit of the Father and the Son, to say to you, always and everywhere, speak Lord, for your servant heareth. Amen. Prayer for the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit. O Lord Jesus Christ, who before ascending into heaven, did promise to send the Holy Spirit, to finish your work, in the souls of your apostles and disciples. Deign to grant the same Holy Spirit to me, that he may perfect in my soul, the work of your grace and your love. Grant me, the Spirit of wisdom, that I may despise the perishable things of this world, and aspire only after the things that are eternal. The Spirit of understanding, to enlighten my mind with the light of your divine truth. The Spirit of counsel, that I may ever choose the surest way of pleasing God and gaining heaven. The Spirit of fortitude, that I may bear my cross with you, and that I may overcome with courage all the obstacles that oppose my salvation. The Spirit of knowledge, that I may know God, and know myself and grow perfect in the science of the saints. The Spirit of piety, that I may find the service of God sweet and amiable. And the Spirit of fear, that I may be filled with a loving reverence towards God, and may dread in any way to displease Him. Mark me, dear Lord, with the sign of your true disciples, and animate me in all things with your Spirit. Amen.